Recognizing text from an image or a picture that you take in your .NET MAUI application has never been easier than with the Plugin.Maui.OCR library. Let's check it out in this video. You've heard that right. There is now a library that makes it super easy to add OCR functionality to your .NET MAUI application on Android, iOS, Windows, macOS, all the platforms that are supported by .NET MAUI, which is really amazing. And it hooks into the platform native functionality for OCR. No third-party libraries or services or whatnot, just whatever is available on the platform, exactly the way that .NET MAUI is built as well. And you can pick an image from your file system. Maybe you've downloaded something from the internet, or you have some kind of document that you want to get the text out of. You can use that, or you can take a picture with the camera on the device. Actually, without any further ado, let's just hop over to my screen share and show you all the goodness that is inside of this library and how easy it is to implement. Before we dive straight into Visual Studio, let's have a quick look at the GitHub repository right here. This wonderful library has been created by Corey Francis. Thank you so much for doing this and making the .NET MAUI ecosystem even richer than it already is. This library, just like many others, is completely open source. Dear viewer, if you land here on this page, and you should, then the very least that you can do is star this repository. It's completely free, and it will let Corey know that you've seen this video and also that you appreciate his work. So definitely do that. And then if you want to take it a step further, if you're going to use this library and it saves you a ton of time, consider sponsor Corey for a little bit. Okay, this is the only way that we can make open source a little bit more sustainable. So the other cool thing before we move on, really cool, is that Corey used my plugin.maui.feature repository for this, which is a GitHub repository that can kickstart your plugin, your .NET MAUI plugin that you want to build for yourself. So definitely go check that out. I have a video on that as well, down in the video description or right at the end of this video. So make sure to stick around. Now, with this, let's scroll down here a little bit, and I'm going to show you all of this, so don't worry too much about it. It's also available for Xamarin still. Xamarin, not supported anymore when you see this video, so definitely get over to .NET MAUI, but if you still need to use this for Xamarin, it is here. For MAUI, for all the platforms, iOS, Android, Windows, macOS, all supported. Super, super cool. And why am I making this? I think this is actually super cool. We'll get to that later in this video. I think Corey had a need for this library himself to scan a certain number from an image, and he just implemented that and made it available for free, open source, for us to use as well, which is super really amazing. Now, the rest is here, like, hey, it's available on NuGet, supported platforms, pattern matching, I'll get to that in a little bit, and then he writes, like, hey, how to set up and do all that things. I'm going to show you that right now. Now, let's go over to Visual Studio, where I created a new .NET MAUI project right here, so this is all there. I prepared a couple of little things already, but I will talk you through that, don't worry. Let's go over to our Solution Explorer first, right-click on our project, and then do Manage NuGet Packages. And there we're going to search for plugin.maui.ocr. This one should pop up right here, and you can see at the time of recording, the latest version is 1.0.8. I've already installed it, but typically you will just click the Install button, next, finish, and it should be on your project. So with that out of the way, actually, let me point out one more thing. Let's go back to our Solution Explorer, right-click on our project and do edit project file. Here we can see the contents of that. Scroll all the way down. I tried to deploy to Android, and I will report a bug to the repository right after this video, because when I tried to deploy to Android, I would run into this weird error of like, hey, it's defined multiple times, some kind of Java type, looked very scary. But I figured out that you have to install just for Android this extra package reference, and that would fix it. So if you run into a weird deployment error for Android, just add this. The code for this whole project is going to be on my GitHub. Find the link down below in the video description. But just install this, and now it would deploy to Android. But, you know, I don't know. Maybe this is specific to me. I don't know if Corey can do anything about this, but we'll see. At least I'm going to report it. So that's there just for you to know if you run into that. Okay. With that out of the way, we're going to have to initialize this plugin for a little bit. So let's go over to our MAUI program. And what you want to do is here at this builder, you can do it wherever you want. I typically do it here, is use OCR. metadata.ocr. I'm not sure if it's like capitals or what's going on here. IntelliSense is not really helping me, so let's figure it out. Use OCR, there we go. Using plugin.maui.ocr. So what it's going to do is going to help me figure this out with the casing, and then it add this using right here, plugin.maui.ocr. And now we're all set with this basically. Now with, because he followed kind of like my pattern for these plugins, which is really cool, you can now do multiple things. You can register it for dependency injection. So I'm just going to show you right here, builder.services.addSingleton, right? You can add this as a singleton probably. Is you can say, hey, the OCR, what is it? OCR, IOCR service then, I guess. So we can just do that one with the plugin.maui.ocr and then the OCR plugin right here, and then the dot default, right? So just the default instance. Actually, I think we can leave all of this out because we have that using right at the top. So we can just do this, or you can even leave this one out as well because it will infer that because it implements the IOCR service. So you can do it like this, and now you can inject it inside of your page as well. So if we would also register the main page right here, you could inject it in your main page. But I'm just going to use the straight object right here. I'm just going to do that just so you have the two options. Let me add this. Use with dependency injection so that you have a reference in the sample code right here. So we've got that. But what I'm going to do is do the straight use it. So here in the main page, I'm just going to reuse this button right here, the take picture button. We'll get to that in a little bit. I've added that as well already. But here we have the pick. Let's do pick image right here. Picks an image for OCR. Here we go. On counter clicked. I'm just going to leave that as it is. And I'm going to go to the code behind for this thing. So main page. Here we go. Code behind. Okay, so this is just the counter clicked stuff. And I'm going to replace all this, right? So I'm going to remove all of this. And also this count one right here. And what I'm going to implement is that we're going to pick an image and we're going to recognize the text from that, right? So the one thing that you might want to do, it's not strictly necessary, but what you can do is do the init as well. So OCR plugin.default, and then we have this init async. Now looking at the code, and you want to do this async, right? So you probably want to do this in the override on appearing, something like that. And then do it like this, and then we can actually do async, right? Because we can do async constructors, so we can do this async and then await, and then it's awaited properly. And I think looking at the code, at least for one platform, the only thing this does is populate the supported languages, which can be very useful information. But I think if you don't want to use that, then you don't really need to do this init. But just to be sure, right, you want to probably have this in here. So just init that library here as well, so that it has all the values that you want to use. And now we can start using the functionality here. So what we want to do first is actually do the media picker, and we're going to pick something. So let's say var pick result is media picker dot default as well. So same pattern here, kind of like the MAUI APIs use that same thing. Pick photo async, there we go. And we need to await this as well, right? So await async, and whenever you do this, whenever you do async void, you probably want to make sure to have a try catch as well so that it doesn't swallow like all the exceptions. So let's pretend that we're actually good developers here. There we go. And here we can say await display alert error exit message, and some AI is helping me to type this so you don't have to watch me do it. Great. I love this. So we have that. And then we have like this pick result. And we're getting this result from that. We probably want to check like if it's not null, right? So the AI is picking up on that too, which is great. And then we're going to go further, and we're going to say var image as stream, right? We want to have the image stream from this is pick result open read async. That's what exactly what we want. So this will open the picked image as kind of like a stream, right? So we can get all the bytes out of there. And we probably want to do a using, right? Because a stream, we need to clean that up whenever it's done. All kinds of programming patterns right here. Don't worry about it too much. And now what we can say is, hey, we can get the stream as bytes. Because if we look at like the OCR plugin, plugin. So let's do await OCR plugin dot default dot, and we can actually explore the APIs here. So we have that init async. We can start recognize text, which kind of like does it in the background. So then it will go off in a background thread, start recognizing the text. Maybe you have a lot going on there, and it will fire this event recognition complete whenever it's done. So you can just, you know, have your user continue their work, and then whenever it's done, you can populate something right there. Or you can just do recognize text, which will do it kind of like wait for the result there in place. And I'm not going to recognize a lot of text right here, so that's just the thing that I'm going to do. So that's kind of like the most APIs that you got right here. And then the supported languages, like I mentioned, you can get the supported languages from the platform to see like, hey, what languages can it actually pretty accurately detect, right? So there's that as well. So let's look at the recognized text async, and you will see that this needs a byte of image data, right? So a byte array. So we're going to have to come up with a byte array from that stream, which is not that hard, so stick with me. And then we have try hard, and that's kind of like the trade-off between like, hey, how accurate do I want the results to be and how long can it take? The try hard will do a longer processing the text, but it will produce more accurate results, right? So just play with that a little bit and see what works for you. And then we have a cancellation token that I still have to make a video about. So if you're still waiting for the cancellation token video, let me know down in the comments below. Come up with that byte array, and we're going to say var image as bytes, let's do that, is, and then we can say, hey, new byte image as stream.length, right? So we're going to initialize a new byte array which has the size of the image that we picked, and then we can say await. Well, actually, it's helping me brilliantly here. Well, I can do this a little bit better. Await image as stream dot read async, and we don't need to specify like all of that. We can just say image as bytes, and that's kind of it. So we don't need all the rest that was suggested to us here. And now it kind of like copies that stream into the byte array we initialized, and we can use that to actually recognize our text right here. So that's kind of like all we need to do. We need to catch the result. Var OCR result is this, so we get the result back. And then the result is also interesting. OCR result dot, we have a couple of things. Is it a success? Yes or no? So let's check that. If success, if not success, then we're going to say await display alert, no success, error, no OCR detected, I don't know, something like that, or possible, detected is not right, possible. Just, you know, you can handle that better in your code. This is just sample code. I can get away with this, okay? And then we'd want to do return, right? So we don't want to do anything further. But if it is a success, which we're totally going to assume, then we can do display alert, OCR result, OCR result.text. Well, not a text, okay? So AI got it wrong here a little bit. But the OCR result has a couple of things. So the success, we've already seen that. We can get the all text, which is just what I'm going to use, just a big string with all the text in there. But you can also get the elements, which is a element object. So if we look at the element, which is an array, and you can see like, hey, this has the text, it has the confidence, like, hey, how sure is it that that is actually the correct text, the width, the height, so we will get the bounding box of all the text. So this is really powerful stuff, the x, the y, so you can get like all the details of where the text is in the image that you just saw. And then you can also get the lines, which is kind of like all text but then in like lines, an array of strings as well. But I'm just going to go with all text, and we're going to see all the text here. So that's enough. Let's actually run this on Windows. I'm going to deploy this on Windows first, and then I'm going to pick an image from the file system. That's what we just implemented, and it should show us the text of that image that I've just picked. Actually, I forgot one thing. Picture button clicked with correct signature was not found. Okay, that's because I was doing this button. So let's just comment this out for a little bit and now try to redeploy to Windows again. Now it should work because that's the next thing that we're going to implement. And I'm going to go over that a little bit faster, where you use the camera to actually snap a picture and use that. So that's really cool as well. Here we go. The Windows is coming up. The Windows application, pick image. It will bring up the image picker or the file picker that is supposed to work on Windows. I'm going to do this one, and it will do, oh, please subscribe to my channel. Well, isn't that convenient? this is your signal. Subscribe to my channel right now and like this video if you've liked what you've seen so far. So you can see this is like super fast and it's only a couple of lines of code to get the image, get the OCR result in here. So that's super cool. For Android, we want to do something extra. So actually we need to, of course, like if you're going to use the camera, you need to add the permissions for the camera, right? So we need to add that, but we need to add an extra thing which is in the readme of this plugin. So don't worry, go check that out. Or of course in the repository for the sample code, we're going to go to this Android manifest and I'm going to do right click open with and then XML text editor. And then inside of this application node, actually, I want to do a thing. And I'm going to copy it here off screen. We need to add this little piece of metadata right here so that we have this MLKit vision, because that's what it uses in the background for Android, value OCR, just so we let the App Store know and I don't know, the system know that we are using this functionality, which is, you know, something that the operating system needs to know about. Now, if you want to also use the camera, we want to copy and paste this. We want to say, hey, camera. And I know that if we want to use the media picker to actually capture an image, we also need write external storage. So we got that in place. And I will make sure that the sample code has the right permissions for iOS and macOS as well, so you don't need to worry about that. So we got all that in place. Now let's uncomment in the XAML our other button. So this button is going to do the almost the exact same thing, but now it's going to actually capture a image from the camera. So actually let's create this clicked handler again. Let's see if IntelliSense can do that for us. There we go, new event handler. And we got this event handler and it follows kind of like mostly the same pattern. I would say I can just copy this. I'm just gonna paste it in here. And it gives me a lot of squiggles because I need to do the async then here. And now I'm not going to do pick photo, but I'm going to do capture photo, right? So I'm going to do capture photo. All the rest, exactly the same, right? So I probably shouldn't duplicate all of this code, but all the code is exactly the same. So whenever I run this now, I could just switch this over to run on Android. I have my local device right here, my Samsung, whatever, whatever. I deployed it beforehand, so I'm not going to wait on that right now, but I have deployed it right here for you. Let me share the screen of my Android device so that this demo is a little bit interesting for you as well. This application that you see right here is Phone Link, which is built into Windows, and you can use that with, I think, mainly Samsung Android phones, which is really cool. You can just cast your screen on here like this. So if I do this now, I can just do take picture. I can get the permissions, right? So that's something that you need to do while using the app. That's fine. It's going to bring up the camera. Ah, that's the wrong camera. I'm going to do the other camera. And you can see here, if I just snap a picture of this, let's make sure, I don't know how, if I can do it a little bit like skewed or something. Well, let's just take this one and do okay and see what it comes up with. And actually it's not that bad, right? Like this is text that we actually recognize from on screen, the code that I just took a picture of, MAUI OCR sample, main page, image as stream, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So you can also just use that, take a picture with your physical device right here and recognize the text that way. Now, how amazing is this OCR in your .NET MAUI application? To be very honest, I was really surprised at how easy it was to install and use this plugin. Not that I don't trust Corey, but usually whenever you're working with images or taking pictures and then OCR, not always that stable, but this plugin is just install it and boom, you will get the OCR results, which is really, really cool. Now, one thing that I didn't really go into because it wasn't in the public NuGet just yet, it was merged like 2 days ago at the time of recording for this video, is that you can do some sort of pattern matching. So Corey now implemented functionality so that you don't get like back all the text and you have to do the parsing yourself, but you can just say, hey, I'm looking for a pattern, which is a couple of numbers, because Corey had this scenario where he wanted to look for a healthcare number or something and an identifier number. And you can just take a picture or select the image and it will return only the text that will have that number. And you can specify the pattern completely yourself. So if you want to look for only a certain word or something like that, you can implement that and the OCR library will do all of that for you. Really, really amazing. If you want to learn more about that, please let me know down in the comments and I will make a follow-up video whenever that is released. I hope this has served your purposes. If you haven't forgotten about that video for creating your own plugin yet, you're like, yes, I'm inspired. I want to create my own plugin. Please check out this video right here for that. And I'm looking forward to all of your amazing .NET MAUI plugins. And I'll see you for that video.